is always in bed. They said City Soaps is the place you ought to be. So the Beverly Hillbillies became Dynasty 3. The Clampets, that is. Well, it looks like George Bush parachuted toward Hooterville, and he landed on his head, caught a case of amnesia, and now he thinks it's Elvis. Well, he caught a ride to Hooterville with Jed, Granny, Pee-wee, and Dr. Ruth. And let's see what's happening in the car.
Well, how you doing back there, fella?
Well, at the record show, I took the blows and did it my way.
Well, I sure will.
Jed, what you talking about?
Maybe he has a sexual dysfunction which has driven him insane. Let me check.
Ow!
Now, what do you think when I grab you there?
Treat me like a fool, treat me mean and cruel, but love me and let me be your teddy bear.
Sounds normal to me.
Check me next.
You're very sick boy, Pee-wee.
I know you are, but what am I?
I love a snappy repartee. Meanwhile, back in Hooterville, let's see what happens.
Hello, Alexis Colby here, huh?
Oh, hail to Miss Alexis. This here is Eustace Haney. I've managed to buy up every available square foot of land I could find in the valley.
Oh, excellent, Mr. Haney. When the government puts in all those new installations to make Arnold happy for voting for them, they're going to need land to put them on. We stand to make a fortune. Oh!
And don't forget all them lucrative construction contracts. We stand to land, too.
Oh, indeed. I haven't, Mr. Haney. Believe me, I do have a feeling that I've forgotten something, though. I can't think of what it might be.
What could that be, Miss Alexis? Oh, you seem to have covered it all.
No, I remember, Mr. Haney. Can you think of a way that we can corner the market on unwed mothers? Those welfare checks add up to big money, you know.
By golly, Miss Alexis, you make me proud to be an American. That's the kind of thinking that made America great.
Well, I don't know about that. Meanwhile, ringside at the great political debate, let's listen as Ellie Mae and Jethro talk.
Jethro, where you been? The debate's half over.
I couldn't help it, Ellie Mae.
I say it. What happened to you? You got a black eye and your clothes is all ripped.
I got caught doing my not spy work by commie agents.
What commie spies?
You's right about Kate daughters being spies. I was watching them take a shower, and I heard Bobby Joe tell Billy Joe something about a 36D. And when I tried sneaking closer, they caught me and beat me up to something awful.
You got to be more careful, Jethro.
Yeah, and I got to find out about this 36D stuff. I think it's some kind of death ray or something.
Well, maybe Jethro ought to be studying the Frederick of Hollywood catalog a little closer. Is Alexis a great American, and does George Bush like peanut butter and banana sandwiches, and is he getting fatter now? Tune in next time and find out on Dynasty 3 to Now. It's time to say goodbye to Jed and all his kin, Alexis, Blake, Granny, and all in their Hollywood send-in. You're all invited back next week to this locality to see what happens to families who inbreed on TV. Y'all come back now. You hear?
Yeah.
And you may miss it.
Prices plus tax, title, and license, 10% down, 11.25 APR.
Fellas, I'm ready to get up and do my thing.
Go ahead.
I want to get into it, man, you know.
Go ahead.
Like a sex machine, man.
Yeah.
Moving, doing it, you know.
Yeah.
Can I count it off?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4.
It's the universe's favorite sports quiz. Sports or consequences. Brought to you by Bud Light. Everything else is just alike. Now, here he is, your congenial host, Gary Burbank.
Thank you and welcome to Sports Consequences on 700 WLW. We are aficionados, but we do have gummy bears. We have, what do you know?
Whatever you said before.
You must know your ranking.
A sports dweeb.
We have one dweeb who is up from Cub. And, of course, a sales gerbil who's come in. I appreciate that, Rick. Rick is very good at this this game anyway.
I'm good at coming in.
Now, okay, we have some very tough questions today, too. And a polite round of applause for the folks who've come by to cater Sports Consequences today. Alan and Rick, catered by Walls Corner Cafe, Carthage on Bay Street. Yeah! Thank you guys for coming. That is some real good banana cream. Is that banana cream pie? Yeah, it's real good. I really like that. All that stuff you brought was great. Thank you. Appreciate it. You guys any good at sports, too?
Frank Pastore.
That's all you have to know about sports. Our kind of guy right there. Okay, we'll get to our first contestant. But first, here is the Sports of Consequences Studio Orchestra, all the way from Buddy Rogers Music.
In the background, you heard our Note for Hunger. Today,
They haven't been catered in quite some time. In case someone wanted to... Where? I thought where they are later. Where? They're holding a note until they're catered. Da-da. What is the song?
Song for Sound of Music.
Oh, it is?
Yeah. Da-da, Julie Andrews.
Sounds more like something by Sid Vicious.
Does it?
It's not like somebody's horn is stuck, too, doesn't it? How can he hold it that long without taking a breath? Sports Consequences, Sony Orchestra.
Mr. Bimbleman.
Yes, Fenwick?
Meet our new advertising agency for Bimbleman's Light Beer.
Sir!
Look, there's no need to salute me.
Yes, sir!
People, I want to outsell Bud Light.
They're working on a slogan, sir.
How many of you have tried my beer?
Oh, gee.
Well, we drew straw, sir, and the loser, the winner, that is, tried it.
Well, where is he?
He's no longer with us.
Oh, what do most of you drink?
Bud Light.
Oh.
Yeah, Bud Light's great for drinking with folks you know.
Or folks you don't know.
Or folks you know but don't know it.
Oh, folks you know.
Hey, Bud Light's good for everybody.
Right.
So what's my beer good for?
Fellas, anybody?
Loosening rusted lug nuts on old pickup trucks?
Yes.
When it comes to smooth taste, one light outshines them all. Bud Light.
So people, tell them the new slogan you came up with.
When you want a beer real bad, we've got a real bad beer. Bimbleman's Light.
What do you think, sir?
Do they have to say bad twice?
Ask for Bud Light, because everything else is just a light. Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Kick him in the knee. Kick him in the leg.
Ow.
Come on, leg. And that's what I'm saying.
Yes, Sega's about our highest ranking member today. It's a long time since you've been the highest ranking. Everybody else is on the DL, actually. Trump is on the DL. He's not feeling well.
Like a coup.
Yeah,
ET
yeah.
Will come through.
Andy Mack's on the DL.
Russ kind of laying back.
Have you noticed how our show seems to take the same way the Reds seem to go sometime like that? Notice that? A lot of guys on the DL right now trying to go back. They're all quiet about that.
Better get to the questions.
Okay, this is our first contestant, Cliff. How are you, Cliff?
All right, Gary.
You ready for us here?
Yeah, I'm ready anytime you are.
We got a bunch of upstarts in here, so let's see if you can... You can take them.
Okay, it's kind of significant that this question happens when Trumpy's at a golf tournament.
Yeah, it is. It must be a golf question.
Yes, it is.
Okay.
Okay, my question is, name the five gentlemen who have won consecutive U.S. Opens, and being in abidance with the Sports of Consequences rules, since there are two of them that were before 1927, I will give you those.
Okay, good.
The first one was Willie Anderson, who is the only three-time in consecutive order.
Okay.
And then John McDermott in 1911, 1912.
We wouldn't have known those anyway, but they're shaking their heads. They would have known those. Wait a minute. You guys can't know this. You know the other three, you think? Russ, go ahead.
Bobby Jones?
I'm sorry?
Bobby Jones, he said.
Robert Jones Jr., yes, sir.
Look here.
Ralph Goodall, or Goodall?
1937-38.
Get it on, Russ. And the man who my clubs are named after, Ben Hogan.
Mr. Hogan is correct.
We know best around, hey.
You guys are doing pretty good the first time out here. What do you think of that, Cliff? That was just... an upstart gummy something. What are you, a gummy what?
I was a gummy worm.
A gummy worm, I think. We'll promote you to gummy... gummy dweeb.
No, I'd rather stay a gummy worm.
You want to stay a gummy... You can refuse a promotion if you want to. Fine. We don't have to pay a higher salary. Then. Thanks for calling, Cliff.
I am astounded.
Nah. He was good. He got you on there. Okay. Hello, Joe.
How's it going, Gary?
Fine. How's Mom and Nim?
Well, they be doing fine. How's your Mom and Nim?
Oh, they're doing just fine, too.
Good.
Well, what do you think, Joe?
Got a soccer question for you, Garrett.
A soccer question?
Yes, sir.
Well, Andy Furman is here. He seems to do well with soccer.
All right. Name for me, please, the German soccer player, famous player, who captained the 1974 World Cup team for West Germany, and then the Cosmos had him come over to play for a while.
Ach, du lieber!
Easy,
Franz, really?
Franz Beckenbauer.
Franz Beckenbauer der Kaiser, that's right.
Yeah! We don't mess around, hey!
Franz Beckenbauer, how do you know that stuff?
Cosmos.
You were...
He played with Gerd Müller in Germany, who was the bomber.
Right.
And Gerd Mueller played for the Fort Lauderdale Strikers.
Amazing. These guys are...
Yes.
Rick, I'm amazed. Yes. How about yourself?
Well, I just wanted to give him that one. I know.
Oh, yeah, Rick knew that all the time, yeah. Thanks for calling in,
Joe. Thanks,
so far, so good.
I'm like, Doc, let's give these guys a pull-out line. Just you and I. Very good. Oh, yes. You guys are hot.
Blown up these 1 minute.
Our next contestant on Sports or Consequences.
Billy Martin fired again.
Wait a minute. No. We have this just in.
Is that right? Oh.
Billy Martin has been fired again. No kidding. Who was put in his place? Do you know? I know he wasn't getting along with the general manager.
Back on the field. He moves down from general manager back to the dugout.
Who?
Lou Piniella.
Lou Piniella is back in the Yankee dugout. And so Billy 5 is over.
Billy kind of predicted it, too.
Stand by next summer for Billy 6. Yeah, it was, they've been talking about this happening. I didn't think...
He may be back before the All-Star break, you know.
Yeah, that's probably true. It didn't have that long to go for the Yankees. How would you like to work for George Steinbrenner? Oh, that's amazing. So Billy Martin, Billy 5 is over, and it seems that Lou Piniella 2 is not going. This is Lou Piniella's second trip, right? As manager of the Yankees. Okay. Well, let's get back to this. Larry?
What a blockbuster announcement.
Yeah, we just got you right there as you were on the air.
Who was the 1946 World Series MVP?
1946 World Series MVP. That was, Cardinals?
Cardinals versus Red Sox.
Okay, Cardinals versus Red Sox. And Russ is just...
beaming.
beaming is the right answer, I think.
Yeah.
Ready to jump at you.
Get
here.
Him, Ross.
You know that?
About Enos Country Slaughter.
Incorrect.
Oh. That's a good one from there, though. Not Enos Country Slaughter. Was it a Cardinal?
I don't know what team he played on.
Well, look at his hat.
Not sure.
Yeah.
I will give you this hint, though.
Okay.
He was a pitcher.
He was a pitcher. What was it? Is it a name that we'd recognize, you think?
I don't know.
Uh-oh.
I don't want to mislead.
But you're not sure if he was a Cardinal or...
No. He won 3 games.
He won 3 games in the 46 World Series.
Ooh.
Boy, that's something to think about here. I don't... let's see. I can't think of a Cardinal. It wouldn't be Dizzy Dean, I guess.
And his nickname... I'll give you his nickname.
Okay.
The Big Cat.
The Big Cat. The Big Cat. Boy, who could be known as the Big Cat?
Better think about this one.
Well, it is hard. Don't we have any tries at all on this? Anybody got a try? Alan, you got a try over there? You got anything? Big Cat. Who is known as the Big Cat? Would he ever play for the University of Kentucky?
No.
I was trying to get yes. Was he real tall? Let's see, the Big Cat. Well, I'm lost. I think we're going to be out of it here because no one seems to know. And, wait a minute. Wait, Senior Smoke is usually pretty good at this stuff. Senior Smoke, you got any idea? 46 World Series. He was called the Big Cat, played for the, either the Cardinals or the Red Sox.
Harry the Cat Brickeen.
Is it Harry Brickeen?
Yes, it is.
Ah! We don't mess around. Hey,
that a boy done. Came right through there. Amazing. Hey, Larry, thanks for calling.
Or Smoke.
Oh, yeah, you got Smoke that time. Don, I can't believe that.
Yes.
Boy, that was hot. Go ahead, Don.
Okay, let's do the news.
This news radio update is brought to you by the Mid-Ohio Sports Car Course, featuring the Chase Vintage Grand Prix this weekend only.
Good afternoon. Don Webb here with a preview of the 4:30 headlines. 10 governors in Chicago today meeting, trying to come up with some recommendations on what can be done to help out in the current drought situation. 39 pit bulldogs killed today. Their executions ordered by a Wilmington judge. Police say the body of that man found in English woods was purposely set on fire. And as you heard them say earlier, Billy Martin is out again. Billy 5 fired and Lou Piniella takes over. We'll have details at 4:30 on News Radio 700 WLW.
The power's off, the electric to the lights. Dixie Highway and Turkey Foot heads up to the intersection there. They say it's going to be a while, too. North and southbound 75, they're both slow between GE and the distillery through the Cross County Highway construction area for road work. And downtown traffic's still a little bit lighter than usual this afternoon. A lot of people playing at the parks, not too many people working. It's okay, though, if you can get away with it. Mike Redden, 700 WLW Airborne Traffic.
Unique
Blend Mix Iced Tea this refreshing.
Jim Mueller, Sears Auto Center mechanic.
People ask, are we open early in the morning? Yes, I say. In the evening? Yes, I say. Then real quick, I say, weekends too. I'm always thinking ahead.
Right now, think about saving 40 to 50% off April 88 prices on Sears SuperGuard response radios with a steel belt wrapped in DuPont Kevlar for extra strength. As low as $32.99 for the P155 ADR13, but only while quantities last.
Hey, Sears installs confidence when lots of places aren't even open.
Answer! We want an answer!
Girls, we don't have a question yet.
Answer!
Well,
answer!
Well, let me get a question
we want
first.
An answer.
Hello, this is Jack. Hello, Jack.
Hi. Answer.
Okay, Jack, you want to try us here?
Okay. In 1971, a Canadian National League soccer player was traded for a soccer ball. Please name the player.
A Canadian National League soccer player was traded for a soccer ball?
Soccer ball.
Was he a little short, round guy or something? Why?
Could he roll?
Yeah, can you explain this to me? How was he traded for a soccer ball?
Hello?
Hello, Jack.
Hi.
How was he traded for a soccer ball?
Well, he was just such a bad player. Well, anyway, he was a Hungarian, okay?
He was a Hungarian.
He came over and he said he was a super soccer player.
Yeah.
So this team named the Kickers, Concordia Kickers, kidnapped him. They made him sign on to a contract. Okay.
Yeah, that's wild. Okay.
And then, such a bad player, he couldn't even make the second string.
The second string, so they traded him for a soccer ball, huh?
Right.
And we're supposed to know who this is.
Right.
All right, Jack, I don't know about this.
Don't we have a multinational or anti-multinational
we do
rule in the rule book?
I mean, yeah. I'll tell you what we do have.
Hungarian,
we do.
He played in Canada,
and
he was traded for a soccer ball.
He was traded for a soccer ball, and you expect us to know this. Is it a name? Okay, is it a name that we would know? A famous name?
I never heard of him.
You never heard of him?
Mm.
Well, I think that's all we need for a case here. All in favor of this being minutia, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
Me?
Uh-oh.
M-I-C.
See you later.
K-E-Y.
Yeah, he's gone. Why? Because that question is minutia.
And we don't answer Mickey Mouse questions. Well, these girls get a little upset about Mickey Mouse questions like that, so we bounced him out, though. We didn't blow him up.
If we ever do have a soccer question that is, you know, of a minor league, we could answer it, but it has to deal with the soccer team that Jim Scott owned locally. For
Jim did own a soccer team. Locally, yeah. You might see him about owning a basketball team, in fact. Jim probably would put up some money for that, yeah.
Excellent, Doc.
Yeah, thanks, Doc. Okay, let's see. What time is it here? We got...
more.
What happened to the Jeopardy question? They had a guy call up on line 5, and now he's gone away. Mark.
From the cafe, we're going to answer that one, too.
Really?
Yeah.
So
they had that.
Okay, well, let's do it anyway. Mark called and wanted to know the first person to score 1,500 NHL points. So go ahead, then. We have an idea here? Go ahead.
Could it be Gordie Howe?
Gordie Howe? That must be right, so...
We don't mess around, hey!
No one said no, did they?
Nobody's arguing.
Well, we'll take that answer, then. Let's get somebody at random. Yes, hello, who's this?
Hello, Gary.
Yeah, who's this?
It's Jack.
Hi, Jack, how are you?
I've got a good Jeopardy question.
Jack, we've already had a person named Jack on, but I think it's okay.
Well, this is Jack 2, then.
Okay, Jack 2 is a different name, isn't it? Yeah. Is that Roman numerals?
It can be.
Close enough. Okay, Jack, if you'll do the Jeopardy question, we'd certainly appreciate it.
Now that the NBA season has concluded,
yep.
I have a question for you.
All right.
Name the three players in the history of the NBA that have made the All-Star game every year they played.
Every year they played. Dr. J?
That's one of them.
Okay.
Yes.
Kareem?
Nope.
Not Kareem.
How about...
Really?
Michael Jordan.
Nope.
Well, Michael Jordan hasn't? Go ahead.
I'll give you this hint. The other two are retired.
The other two?
Well, they're all retired.
Okay.
Dr. J just concluded.
Okay. We'll get two of them if we can and leave one open, okay? Okay, Dr. J is one. Then we should try a retired person. Oscar Robertson.
Wrong.
Okay, Will Chamberlain.
No. Bill
Not
Russell.
Will Chamberlain. Bill Russell.
Nope.
Whoa, are these
Bob
names?
Cousy.
Bob Cousy.
Nope.
John Halpin.
Jerry West.
Jerry West is one of them.
Okay, Jerry West, yes. We got two. Okay, hold on. It is up to you now to get the last one. I gave you two.
Hey.
I gave you two. Gary gave
Excellent.
You two.
The announcer
Excellent. Gave you two. Remember that?
Yes,
remember that? And let's see.
Let's see anything.
First caller, look at it. Hung up. He knew what to do. Polite person making way for caller two, who is hello.
Hello, this is Pete.
Pete, go ahead. What do you think?
Who is Elgin Baylor?
Who is Elgin Baylor? Good answer. We're all thinking yeah on that. Who is Elgin Baylor?
Incorrect.
Incorrect. Good try, though.
Okay.
Good try. Okay, back. Hello, who's this? Hello?
Are you there?
Hello, who's this?
Link.
Go ahead. Who do you think it is?
Will Chamberlain.
I tried Will Chamberlain. He said no, but I would think it would be. Okay, back.
Try it again. You never know.
Well, okay, we tried it again. Could have. You may have changed it. Is it Will Chamberlain yet?
I haven't changed my mind.
Well, good try, though, okay?
Back.
Hello, who's this?
Hey.
Go ahead.
Who is Bob Pettit?
Who is Bob Pettit? Who is Bob Pettit?
Yeah, that man,
Whoa! Hey! He don't mess around, hey!
Who is Bob Pettit? That's good. That's a good question, too. I like that one.
Thank you.
In fact, if you'll hang on, we'll get you a prize, too, for giving us so many hits on that. And getting so many answers, okay?
Thank you.
And we do have big stuff.
Yay! The prize man!
Big stuff we have for you. Home version of Sports Consequences.
Ooh.
We have a Sports Consequences rule book.
Ah.
We have a Sports Consequences mug for Mr. Muggs in Delhi. We have a JT Insufficionado t-shirt.
Ooh.
We have three LaRue Lane bowling passes.
Yeah, baby.
And a new card, a Frank Pastore baseball card. How do you feel?
Absolutely fantastic.
And how do you feel?
I feel great, you're.
Hey. I'm kind of afraid to do this. These guys are upset. They haven't been catered. We've been catered many times. And maybe someday we could talk Alan and Rick from the Walls Corner Cafe to come.
Only you can end the note for hunger.
Where are you guys located again? Your new place. Give us an address here.
They're not going to do that. How are we going to know where to take the food?
They're hungry. No wonder you're hungry. Sort of melancholy, stomach growling stuff here. Do they know how irritating that is? In your headphones.
Yeah,
we got to get these guys some food. They're at Buddy Rogers Music. I think, which location, Don?
They're at the corner of Simpson and Galbraith.
Simpson and Galbraith. If you walk in, you'll hear them holding their notes playing the horns. Simpson and Galbraith, if you have. Take a candy bar by or
a piece of bread.
A piece of bread with mayonnaise on it, mayonnaise on it, would be fine. Sports Consequences, Studio Orchestra. Thank you, guys.
You've just been abused by Sports or Consequences. Brought to you by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light. Some of our contestants receive lovely parting gifts.
Consequences was selected by 1,000 doctors to be chosen to send to some deserted island somewhere. And thanks, Doc. 430 and 700 WLW Cincinnati.
700 WLW News. Good afternoon. I'm Don Webb along with Jeff Henderson at 430. Illinois Governor James Thompson says he wants the Army Corps of Engineers to get permission to divert Lake Michigan to get the Mississippi going and flowing again. Thompson says the low water level caused by the drought has virtually shut down barge traffic. Ohio Governor Dick Celeste and the Michigan Governor say they are opposed to diverting Lake Michigan. Total of 10 Midwest governors in Chicago today trying to come up with recommendations to deal with the drought situation. The governors today heard from Agriculture Secretary Richard Ling, who said the federal government will help out by expanding existing crop insurance and disaster loan programs. The latest forecast that we have, there is a chance of rain, possible chance of rain tomorrow in this area, a 40% chance. Coming up on News Radio 700 WLW, man charged with murder and death of man found in English woods. We'll have that story a bit later. Here's a late word just in. A three-year-old boy who fell into the Laurel Pool on Armory near Lynn Street in the West End has been taken to Children's Hospital this afternoon. The child stopped breathing but was revived at the scene. A Clinton County judge today ordered the execution of 39 pit bulldogs. They had been confiscated after a raid on a home in Blanchester. There has been another arrest in what police call a major dogfighting ring there. 20-year-old Gregory Lowe of Amelia now faces dogfighting charges. Police say the body of a man found in English woods yesterday was purposely set on fire. 20-year-old Irvin Harris Jr. has been charged with murder. According to police, murder happened in Green Township after an argument. Name of the victim still not released. Right now, let's check out traffic.
Yeah, let's do that. They're going to tow a car from the 8100 block of Beachmont Avenue. It's causing a backup outbound on Beachmont right around the 8100 block. And light's still out. Dixie Highway at Turkey Foot heads up through the intersection. The usual construction delays. Other than that, downtown traffic a little bit lighter than usual. Mike Redden, 700 WLW airborne traffic.
The Cincinnati Free Store could use your help due to the current hot spell. They have given out their entire supply of fans. If you have a fan that is working, you can donate it. Call 241-1064.
Pope John Paul today has arrived in Austria for a visit that will include a controversial meeting with President Kurt Waldheim, who has been criticized for his role as a German army officer during World War II days. The Pope will also tour a former Nazi death camp during his stay.
A Turkish news agency says landslides set off by heavy rain may have buried as many as 100 people in eastern Turkey. The landslides tore into a coffee shop and covered a highway. The news agency also says 18 people are known to have been injured.
It's been 40 years since the Berlin airlift, the date observed today, to commemorate the project. A vintage U.S. transport plane is reenacting that airlift, flying from Frankfurt to Berlin. The airlift at the end of World War II, providing food and clothing for 2 million people in Berlin, who were sealed off from the rest of the world by Russian troops.
New government figures show the economy grew at a healthy 3.6% in the first 3 months of this year, but that is not quite as strong as previously thought. Analysts credit the expansion of the gross national product to an export-driven manufacturing boom.
A publicist for Dennis Day says the 71-year-old singer was surrounded by his children and grandchildren when he died last night in L.A. Day, known as the sidekick for comedian Jack Benny, had fought a long battle with Lou Gehrig's disease.
Waterbeds and tea can both be dangerous to health. Today on Medically Speaking, first, waterbeds.
New medical research suggests that waterbeds may be hazardous to newborn babies. Doctors report in the New England Journal of Medicine that a study of sudden infant death syndrome cases found a significant number of babies who had died face down in waterbeds, and they theorize the beds may form a depression from which the infant cannot lift its head to breathe. The doctors are recommending that a general warning be issued.
And if you're a tea drinker,
the drinking of tea may be a factor in increased cholesterol levels. A study conducted by Constance Keyes of the University of Nebraska showed that women who drank a lot of tea, several cups a day, had an increase of low-density cholesterol. High-density cholesterol levels were unchanged. Keyes reported on her limited study at a meeting of food technologists in New Orleans.
I'm Bill Ridenour, News Radio 700 WLW.
When you see news, call the Tri-State's original news tip line, 421-NEWS.
The radar forecast for Dry Ridge, North Bend, and the rest of the Tri-State, mostly clear tonight, a low of 62, partly cloudy tomorrow, a high of 85. Tomorrow night, partly cloudy with a 30% chance of showers, a low of 70. Saturday, partly cloudy, a 30% chance of rain, a high of 88. Right now, it's 89 in northern Kentucky, 89 degrees, also at your official weather station. With Don Webb, I'm Jeff Henderson. Up next, the Wall Street Journal report.
Hey, Vern, it's me, your buddy Ernest. It came from the crock pot. Big creature feature at the drive-in tonight, Vern. You get the little woman and the kids, and I'll get here done. Little Ernie and some of that delicious Nizer ice cream. Nizer ice cream, Vern. So good and fresh and creamy, just like Grandma used to make. Mm-mm. You, me, the wife, the kids, lawn chairs, and Nizer ice cream, all at the drive-in. Now, don't that sound like fun?
Vern, you there, Vernon?
Not those chips, honey. Get the Hussmann's.
Daddy, why do we always buy Hussmann's?
Oh, history, honey, history. In 1788, Colonel Chip Hussmann first braved the wilderness to bring the great-tasting Hussmann potato chips to the Indians of the valley. During Cincinnati's bicentennial, it would be blasphemous to buy any other chip.
Why did the Indians want potato chips, Daddy?
Oh, to eat with their hot dogs and hamburgers. Don't they teach you kids anything in school now?
When the chips are down, be sure they're Hussmann's, Hussmann's potato chips.
Investors took some profits today in the stock market after the Dow Industrials had closed up 25 and 43 points respectively the past couple of trading sessions. The Dow closed down nearly 4 points today at 2148.29 in active trading on some 187 million shares. At Advest in New York, stock analyst Bill LaFave tells us this pause in the market is not surprising.
I do think the market's going to work higher, but I wouldn't be the least bit surprised to see a little pause or a little backing and filling in here, given the huge move on Tuesday and Wednesday this week.
Analyst LaFave, there were 686 advancing issues with 801 lower. The average price per share of Big Board Common was down 7 cents. Precious metals prices were down. Gold lost $2.10 to $450.90 the ounce. Silver down 4 cents to $6.99. The dollar mostly lower while bonds were higher. This is the Wall Street Journal report.
Fred, what's the payroll status?
Running late, Max.
Have you finished adding up payables and receivables?
Well, I'm still trying to separate them.
Oh, what about that order for 600 widgets?
Well, inventory's only showing 600 doodads.
You know, Fred, I think it's time to go to computer land and learn to computerize our accounting.
But we've always done it this way, Max. What if it doesn't work? Take it easy, Fred.
Computer land has accounting solutions we can really count on. Powerful computers.
Ooh, wow.
The latest accounting software.
Ooh.
And training so we'd get geared up fast.
Gee, then our books would balance.
Yes, we'd be on top of inventory, do accurate budgets, plan for the future.
Maybe even give ourselves a raise?
Now you're talking, Fred.
For accounting solutions you can count on, stop by your nearest participating Computer Land store soon. You'll find computer professionals who can advise you, plus training and support to back you up. Computer Land, the one thing to know about computers.
Hey, I'm Bob Hope, and when I want up-to-the-minute, in-depth sports information, I listen to Sports or Consequences with Gary Burbank, 4 o'clock weekdays on 700...
Some of pinching an inch earlier. You know, when we started Sports of Consequences, I couldn't pinch an inch. Now I can pinch an inch on my forehead. It's so bad. But once again, thank you to Wall's Corner Cafe. Wall's Corner Cafe in Carthage on Vine Street. Rick, Alan, you guys did a great job. This is the best banana cream pie I've had in a long time. I can't remember having any better, in fact. It's good stuff. Thanks.
Yeah, $7.
440, 20 until the hour. And,
You gave me the wrong cue there, producer.
I'll draw your hand. Here's your chance to fight the drought. We'll have, caller 7-749-3700. If you can sing How Dry I Am, you win a six-pack of Canada Dry. You can call right now. In the meantime, here's Mike Redner. Check on traffic. Mike?
Traffic light's still out. Dixie Highway and Turkey Foot. And the car's still in the way. The 8100 block of Beachmont Avenue outbound. There's somewhat of a backup there. The construction delays are heavy on 75 north and southbound. 71's not too bad. Eastbound Norwood Lateral, a little bit slow as you come off of 75 until you get past Paddock Road. And Fort Washington Way still looking good downtown. The cut in the hills, not too bad either. Mike Redden, 700 WLW Airborne Traffic.
Thank you, Michael.
I'm doing Al Waterbody all of a sudden here. I don't know why. This is, who please?
Dan.
Hey, Dan.
Yes.
You're calling to sing How Dry I Am?
Yeah, I'm going to try anyway.
I got a six-pack of Canada Dry for you. And you're on the air, Dan.
I'm going to see if I can get some help here.
Oh, that'd be great. I'd like to hear a little choir.
We'll get a whole chorus going.
Oh, that's terrific. Go ahead, yeah.
Here we go. Ready, guys? How dry I am. How dry I am.
Oh, they're good.
Nobody knows how dry I am.
Well, you guys are good, Dan. Are you using the Beatles old harmony type?
Yeah.
That's what I thought it was. Okay. We got a chance for you to get registered for a Culligan water conditioning system worth $1,000. And if you win, John Phillips will fly over your house and water your lawn.
Oh,
not sure how. From the traffic copter, okay?
Okay.
Hold the phone, let Doc get some more info from you, okay?
All right.
26, 1979. 9 years ago, American car manufacturers needed business. So the big three combed the United States for a suitable tent sale location. They chose Florence, Kentucky. That was 9 years ago. Today, American car sales are setting records, but the big three haven't forgotten. Now, for the ninth year in a row, they're back. Ford, Buick, Chevy, Chrysler, Plymouth, Cadillac, Oldsmobile, and GMC trucks. Every car and truck will be sold at factory prices. Discounts as much as $4,500 less than showroom prices. Buy a new 1988 for $5,429 or save as much as 50% on used cars and trucks. And while you're here, enjoy a Conn's hot dog. This sale happens once a year. The only big three tent sale in America. Today through Sunday, Florence Square Shopping Center across from the Florence Mall, Florence, Kentucky. Open tonight till 10.
Jim Mueller, Sears Auto Center mechanic.
People ask, are we open early in the morning? Yes, I say. In the evening? Yes, I say. Then real quick, I say, weekends too. I'm always thinking ahead.
Right now, think about saving 40 to 50% off April 88 prices on Sears SuperGuard response radios with a steel belt wrapped in DuPont Kevlar for extra strength. As low as $32.99 for the P155 ADR13, but only while quantities last.
Hey, Sears installs confidence when lots of places aren't even open.
What could be more beautiful than one perfect pearl? How about a room full of real cultured pearls, all at 60% off the regular price? Locally based Panina Designs, a direct importer and national distributor of fine cultured pearls and jewelry accessories, will offer these beautiful items for a one-time only sale. On June 26th and 27th at the Marriott Hotel on Chester Road in Tri-County, Panina Designs will present quality pearls in every size and color. You'll find silver, white, rose, cream, blue, gray, and even black pearls in any length. The Panina Designs professionals will customize or add perfectly matched pearls to those you now own. Save 60% on quality saltwater and freshwater pearls, Mabes, South Seas, and Baroque pearls in earrings, bracelets, rings, pins, pendants, clasps, shorteners, and enhancers, some including diamonds, semi-precious, and precious stones. Panina Designs is famous for their shows in the nation's leading department and jewelry stores, so don't miss this one-time opportunity. 2 days only, Sunday, June 26th from 12 to 8, and Monday, June 27th from 10 to 9 at the Marriott Hotel on Chester Road.
Just saying, Dennis and Andy Max on vacation still.
Yes, Gary. Billy Martin was fired today again as manager of the New York Yankees, ending his fifth term as skipper of the team.
Can you imagine working somewhere, anywhere, and being fired five times?
No.
What does it say about your employer?
I don't know. It's
I don't think it says much.
It's a zoo.
Either he's got strange judgment.
I thought maybe Dusty Rhodes would be named as manager, you know? I mean,
well,
what the heck?
I'd never thought of that, actually. So
yeah, you never know.
Dusty Rhodes?
You mean our Dusty Rhodes?
Yeah.
I hadn't either.
Oh. You never know.
No.
I mean,
why would you say that?
Well, you never know. I mean, the way it's going up there.
Lou Piniella has moved down, right?
Yes, Lou Piniella is back from the general manager's post, and he's moved back down to the dugout. So it continues in New York.
Yeah, Dusty's a big Yankee fan.
Yeah. Well, you never know. I mean,
might as well have a fan in.
Yeah, that's true.
Because it doesn't matter what else is there.
Bring a different perspective.
So Lou, too, takes over Billy Five.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. The Yankees have lost four straight going into tonight's game versus Cleveland, and they trail first place Detroit in the AL East by 2.5 games. The managerial change today is the 15th for the Yankees since George Steinbrenner took control of the team back in 1973. Also fired today along with Martin were pitching coach Art Feller and two other coaches, Cleet Boyer and George Mitterwald. The Reds have the day off today. They begin a series up against the Western Division leading Dodgers tomorrow night at the stadium, although the action will be right here on the Big One with Marty and Joe. Cincinnati trails first place Los Angeles by 6.5 games in the West. Barry Larkin looks toward the Dodgers' first visit to Cincinnati this season.
Well, we need to play well everywhere now. We're, 6.5, 7.5 games out of first place now. And we can make up a lot of ground playing the Dodgers. There's no one key series for us anymore. I think when we get a little closer before All-Star break, I think we'll be all right.
Baseball this afternoon in the National League, second inning at Wrigley Field. The Cubs lead the Mets 2-0. Hall of Famers Willie Stargell and Bobby Doerr have been named the honorary captains for the upcoming All-Star game July 12th at Riverfront. In tennis, a big second-round upset today at Wimbledon. Chris Martin reports from London.
John McEnroe is out of the 1988 Wimbledon Championships. He's been beaten in straight sets by Wally Masur of Australia, who's ranked 64 in the world. McEnroe held set points in the first two sets, but he lost the first one 7-5 and the second on a tiebreak. Masur then swept to a 3-love lead in the third set, and it was too far for Mac to come back. So despite being seeded 8th by the Wimbledon committee, he's out to a player ranked 64 in the world. Chris Evert, Martina Navratilova, and Jimmy Connors were among the winners, though.
Football coach Jerry Faust will be Bob Trumpy's special guest tonight on Sports Talk starting at 6:05. Faust and other celebrities are in town to play tomorrow in the first annual SIDS Golf Tournament at Boone County. And the 700 WLW Coors All-Stars are in action tonight, Milford High School at 7:30. And our opponents will be...
The Miami Township Police Department, say.
Yes.
7:30 at Wolf and Pheasant Hill Road off Route 28, Milford.
Yes, home of
the Eagles.
Playing
third base, won't you?
I'll be playing third.
Let's get back to this thing with the Yankees now, okay?
Yeah.
How many... Has anyone ever thought, or is there a calculator big enough or a computer big enough to... count how many managers the Yankees have had under George Steinbrenner?
Well, it's the 15th managerial change.
Does he also manage CKY? There's a lot of people changing over there,
you're
too.
You're right.
You know? So I wonder if it's the same thing. Maybe Billy Martin will come in to do afternoons or something. Maybe something else, an alternative or something. Yeah. I just wondered about that. It's kind of strange. So many people. Guy called me up with that.
Thank
well,
you.
Seg, I guess Seg doesn't want to get embroiled in any controversy whatsoever.
He's just the
All-American good guy.
Yes.
And Seg, you can go back and be the All-American good guy, but tonight you're the third baseman who gets all the stuff
against
hit right
the police.
At him. And you
against
gotta
the police.
Yep, and you got to protect us with your body. You got to throw yourself right in front of every ball hit.
Yeah, if you want to see some comic relief, folks, be at Milford tonight.
Bassy.
All right.
This year, the Old Sailor inviting you to the biggest boat buying blast ever held in the tri-state. It's a rip-roaring riverboat sale going on right now at Cincinnati's Boat Discounter, Cincinnati East Marine in Amelia, and Cincinnati North Marine in Fairfield. If you ever thought about owning a boat, now's the time. Brand new boats from just $49.95. Boat, motor, and trailer complete. That's right, new boat, $49.95. How about a 17-foot bow rider, just $59.95, powered with a Merc Cruiser inboard outboard plus FPO? We have too many boats. We must move them out. You can choose from over 100 boats, including Baja, Thundercraft, Raker, and Bomber Bass Boats, and save $1,000, $3,000, up to $5,000 during this limited time sale. With such a huge selection of boats, you don't have to mess around with ordering and waiting. You can buy today and boat today. The competition might not like this sale very much, but I think you're going to love it. The rip-roaring river ride going on right now this week. Today, only at Cincinnati's famous boat discounter, Cincinnati East Marine, Ohio Pike, and Amelia, and the new Cincinnati North Marine on Route 4 in Fairfield, across from Heritage Oldsmobile Cadillac. Tell them the Old Sailor sent you.
This news radio update brought to you by the Fireworks Warehouse in Connersville, Indiana. Call area code 317-825-2976.
I'm Jeff Henderson. Among this hour's top stories, 10 governors meet to discuss the drought, including Ohio's governor. One idea, tap the waters of Lake Michigan. A conversation with a man once held hostage in Iran. And Americans are giving more. Don Webb and I will have the details at the top of the hour on News Radio 700 WLW.
Lights are acting up. Dixie Highway in Turkeyfoot, a wreck, the 2800 block of Madison. A broken down car, 275 at Reed Hartman Highway. Police are there helping the guy out. They're going to call a tow truck for him. And the expressway is pretty much the usual construction delays. Northbound 75 approaching Galbraith, north of the lateral there. Southbound 75 slow from GE down towards Paddock Road. And also the Norwood lateral eastbound a little bit heavy both directions off of north and southbound 75. 71 looks pretty good. Point Washington Way and the cut in the hill, it's in pretty good shape. For the Golden Tee, Mike Redden, 700 WLW Airborne Traffic.
Hey, watch out!
Hey, watch it. There's a kid playing here.
Baby baseball. What brings you to the all-new miniature golf course here at the Golden Tee Golf Center?
My dad. He knows kids love to play miniature golf.
Well, he couldn't have picked a more fun course than the one here at the Golden Tee.
You can say that again. Plus, Dad can come over to the driving range while I play miniature golf.
Talk about your great inexpensive family night out.
Yeah, and a lot more fun than watching reruns on TV. And for that special kid in your life, you can throw a miniature golf party here at the Golden Tee. Got any special dates coming up?
Well, let's see. Special dates.
My birthday's not for a long time, but Baby Baseball tries to do a little something around the All-Star game, and this is the bicentennial year. Think about it.
Hey, Doc.
Cute kid.
Golden Tee Golf Center, I-75 and Sharon Road. A fun night out.
Opryland Travel's got a deal for you. For $98, you get two nights in a Nashville hotel plus three days at Opryland Show Park and Brenda Lee. And music, music, music.
What are you doing?
I'm making the last line rhyme with Brenda Lee.
No. I mean, overall, what are you doing?
Oh, see, this is my big break in the jingle biz. Mm. I can go to Nashville for two nights in a hotel, 3 days at Opryland, go see music, 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 and see a matinee at the Grand Ole Opry for as low as $98.
$98.
No kidding? That's like the price of one night in a hotel.
Hey, that's great. Listen, for the cost of one night in a hotel, you get all this, making the last line
rhyme with hotel. Well, it says here air or ground transportation aren't included in the price, but Opera Van Travel will handle that for you, too, if you want.
Oh, air or ground transportation.
And for more information or reservations, just call 615-